In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful, I bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad, a 1400 years ago, is the last messenger and servant and prophet to the worlds. As I greet you in the greeting words of peace, we say it in Arabic language, the universal greetings of As-Salaam Alaikum, and we add Wa Rahman to Allah, wa Barakah to Him, which means in English, may the peace and mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you. My short topic is part 3 of death to the oppressors. But on this part 3, I want to speak about black traitors that have been used all throughout our history for the benefit of white, pale white supremacy, hatred for black life. I want to quote something from what Marcus Garvey said. He said, I was convicted and sent to prison, not because I defrauded anyone, but because of the wicked enemies of my own race. I would not blame the few whites that contributed to my conviction. Neither will I blame the government. I blame the malicious and jealous Negroes who, for the sake of money, will sell their own mothers. My own black people lied on me, and I was sent to jail for 5 years. Our people are so wicked to themselves, and they are not satisfied until they are telling the enemies something about themselves. Marcus Garvey. And we can look back in history when we had great freedom fighters that fought for our liberation and for our freedom, that in the mix of these freedom fighters' congregations, they had black traitors that would go back and tell the pale white man, the slave master, what they were planning. They were fighting against their own survival. They were fighting against their own livelihood. They were fighting against their own liberation from oppression and slavery from the pale white slave master. Gabriel Prosser was betrayed by one of his own. Denmark Vessey was betrayed by one of his own. Nat Turner, he didn't let his plans be known to them, but what he did say was, who's with me? And when 900 stood up with him and 100 sat down, he said, the first thing that we have to do is kill those 100. Because they will be on the side of the pale white man fighting against us to keep us enslaved, to keep us oppressed, to keep us in a situation and condition of life where our children are getting murdered. We have this same idea amongst our people right today in 2015, going into 2016, and it's been like this all throughout our history. We had black people helping catch blacks in Africa to bring them into slavery for, not for themselves, but for the pale white slave master. That's a sick individual to go against themselves so that we can continue to be hung, arrested, killed and murdered. We have a lot of our people today that have black skin, but their mind and their ways and their thinking is no more than the pale white man and woman. How many black women do you see that always want to call the police, just like pale white people, on the black man, trying to do the same exact thing that they did to Gabriel Prosser, Denmark Vessey, and Marcus Garvey, and all the other black leaders that they have betrayed, trying to get a buttermilk biscuit at the back window of the slave master and their children? How many are living amongst us in Louisville, Kentucky? How many are in our communities? How many are like this? Death God needs to bring to the oppressors. Death is the order of God's ordainment on the land today, because the wickedness has went to such an extreme that the only way to get rid of this wickedness so that we can live in peace and happiness is unless God takes the breath out of these black people with white pale face minds and the oppressors themselves. Death is what is deserved on the oppressors by God's hands. For when wickedness reaches a certain level, there's no more mercy, there's no more forgiveness. In order for us to attain our freedom, in order for us to be truly free as God wants us to be, these enemies amongst our own people, we need to pray for their death. They need to be removed away from us so that we will not continue to suffer police brutality, so that we will not continue to suffer exploitation, so that we will not continue to suffer oppression at the pale-faced white man's hands and those of our people that have a pale face mindset against their own people. Marcus Garvey was convicted and deported because you had integrationists that wanted a buttermilk biscuit to be admitted in the pale white man's society so that we can be exploited and mistreated and misused. They betrayed Marcus Garvey. They contacted the government trying to get him arrested. They contacted the police and we need to get rid of him. We not part of Marcus Garvey. They denounced him at every turn. These are black people wanting to be integrated with slave masters' children, continually lynching us, killing us, hanging us, exploiting us, stealing our land. Marcus Garvey wanted to get a land of our own, go back to Africa and build a nation of our own. So he stopped focusing on trying to integrate with pale white America. He stopped focusing on that. So the integrationists, the slaves of our people, said, no, we want to have to be treated unjustly by the slave master. We want to be exploited. What kind of thinking, what kind of mindset will want to still be a slave and be exploited? Women being raped, have no rights, being lynched and killed. What kind of mindset is that? Why should people want to be misused unless they've been trained and taught to hate themselves? Just like black women getting on TV talking about the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan needs to be arrested because they concocted the lie that he said that we're getting 10,000 black men to kill white people. He never said nothing like that. But this dumb, Tom black woman with a pale-faced white supremacist mind, not realizing that it's hatred against her own black self, got up saying he needs to be arrested, echoing the same racist idea from these racist pale-faced crackers trying to kill us. All the black people that want to help pale white supremacy, hatred for black life, God needs to kill them off the land with these devils, because they have become devils with them. In order for us to get our true freedom, death needs to come to our oppressors. God needs to send death, the angel of death, to take their soul, so that we that want freedom can live in peace and freedom and happiness. For we don't have to carry guns and weapons and go kill people. God will fight our battles and kill them himself. Because when you have an oppressed people, the prayer of the oppressed to God is answered quickly and immediately. There's no barrier between God and the prayer of the oppressed. So when people start dying like that, know for certainty that the oppression has become so great that the oppressed has started praying for the death of the oppressors. And I have no sympathy, I have no mercy, I have no forgiveness for when death comes to them. Because if you are trying to get people arrested, in other words, re-enslave them, you trying to steal everything they have, you trying to take their lives, you trying to do things to destroy others, your life should be destroyed. Your life should be devoid of happiness, and God should take the breath out of your nostrils and kill you dead, so that you would not oppress another person on this earth. God tells us all throughout the Bible, and I'm not even quoting the Quran, he tells us all throughout the Bible that he kills whole populations that rebel against him. He wipes out, murders with an earthquake, destroys with tornadoes and wind and brimstone. The Bible is one of the most violent pieces of reading that you can get. the Bible in the Old Testament is full with war and murder and God killing and wiping out people. When God sends an earthquake or a tornado and wipes out people, know that there is an end to grace. Know that there is an end to mercy. Know that there is an end to forgiveness. Then begins the road of destruction and death, because oppressors, liars, deceivers, tricksters, killers are in the land. And God gives a little grace period, but then ends it and starts the killing. This is God. This is the God that you say is full of love. This is the God that you say is full of grace and mercy and forgiveness. But what you failed to point out is that it also is a God of destruction, a God of murder, a God of death, a God of saying, you're not going to continue in the wicked practice of destroying the earth. So in dealing with justice, he has to be just. And as you reap, as you sow, and as what you give out will come back to you. This is the God of justice. So if you are oppressing others, God will send justice upon you. You trying to destroy people's lives, you trying to get people arrested, God will give justice on you and murder you and take the wind out of your breath and bury you in his grave and bring you back up to him for judgment. This is the prayer of the oppressed, to kill off the deceivers of our own people that have a black, that have black skin but a pale white face mindset, to help kill our people, to help get us arrested, helping the pale white enemy, just like they did Marcus Garvey, just like they did Gabriel Prosser, just like they did Denmark Vesey, just like they tried to do the honorable mentors Louis Farrakhan, just like they do all of our people that fight for our freedom. They need God's wrath and taking the breath out of their nostrils and burying them in the grave to go back to him for judgment, so that we that want freedom can live in peace, happiness, and have the enjoyable life that God wants us to have. As I greet you in the greeting words of peace, we said in the Arabic language the universal greetings of As-Salam Alaikum. And we add Rahman to Allah Barakatuh, which means in English, may the peace and mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you.